So we're back again, and we got a new camera. Brad loaned us a camera. We want to thank Brad, and we were thinking of doing something on Mary Magdalene.
ASKEFC.com.
Just by chance, in the camera bag was a picture, a single picture of
Mary Magdalene.
Silvana Mangano as Mary Magdalene.
So we think that's a sign that we're on the right track with that topic. And we'd like to thank George Bradley for lending us this camera.
Yes.
All right.
So we're going to ask three questions about Mary Magdalene. Who was she? What happened to her? And how to bring her gifts to humanity.
All right.
Okay.
Who was Mary Magdalene? Amazing.
Condescend, powerful, and resuscitate. So they tell us Jesus was resuscitated.
And there are stories that Mary Magdalene actually brought people back from the dead.
Yes.
Like Jesus said to Lazarus.
Right.
And that's certainly a powerful thing.
And we have Pink that came up. What's that?
Of her resuscitating dead people. Or at least it happened once.
There was one story. Yeah. Plus,
and we need to resuscitate her name, basically. You know, she needs to be brought to the public's attention. Because she doesn't really get much credit for what she did. Much positive credit, you know. So, and people are condescending towards the idea of her because of the rumor that she was a prostitute, etc. So, and you know, people are condescending towards women. Well, men typically are condescending towards women. And when you look at the Christian religion, it's all men in terms of the church. They totally left out the Gospel of Mary Magdalene. And it's very male-centric.
And she descended.
And she ascended.
And then she ascended. There's stories that she ascended as well.
Oh my God, look at this. CPR. And it ends with resuscitate. How funny is that?
Oh my God, that's amazing.
That's hilarious. Condescend, powerful, resuscitate. Wow. And perhaps she has some descendants, right? That's another...
Oh, her descendants. Right, they're powerful descendants. That's all the Da Vinci Code. Is that she had children with Jesus.
Makes you wonder.
I kind of like to ask one more question about who she was and just kind of squeeze it in up there.
All right. Seems to be a juicy topic.
Did you see that?
CPR, so funny. All right.
Looks like the internet is stalled again.
Uno momento, por favor. Should I click it again? Let's see.
Yeah.
So, no?
Oh.
Well, I think this one basically says it all. Unfortunately, we lost the signal, but we'll get it back.
Well, there is an interesting story about Mary Magdalene where there's a statue of Peter, who became Saint Peter, who's pointing, telling her to go, and she walks away dejectedly, and she was cast adrift in a little rowboat with no rudder somewhere in the Middle East, and somehow, mysteriously, the winds or whatever brought her to southern France, where there are literally dozens of churches and a whole Mary Magdalene mythos in southern France, and there's a woman who wrote a number of books about Mary Magdalene called The Goddess of the Gospels. So this is a very important topic to needs to be brought to humanity's attention to appreciate the feminine side of life.
Because according to gospels that aren't incorporated into the Christian church, she was basically a miracle worker like Jesus and one of his closest disciples.
And that the men were jealous of her. Why is she getting kissed and why is she getting special tutelage? So the male dominance, pushed her out. Right, pushed her out of the circle, and that it makes more sense that that she and Jesus were actually a pair of divine beings, as opposed to just Jesus alone. And that kicking her out has led to all of the negative things with the pedophilia and the celibacy and all that stuff that's all twisted.
Corruption.
Yeah. So when we get the internet working, we'll come back with these other questions. Hey, we're back. The internet came back.
Hallelujah.
So tell us what we're going to do here.
So now we're going to ask our second question about Mary Magdalene. What happened to her?
Indelible, adaptable secrecy. So the secrecy makes sense right away as far as...
Not sure what indelible means.
Indelible is unerasable.
Oh, okay.
Adaptable.
So although although they tried to keep her thing a secret, still it was indelible. Right? I mean,
yeah,
it's resurfacing. Lots of people are...
Secrecy.
Oh, secrecy. Bear with us, we're working with limited resources here. Okay.
And she was kept secret. But she was very adaptable. Their stories are that when she got to France, she eventually just took up residence in a cave. And there's like a grotto of Mary Magdalene that they found that is wildly lush, and that there's strange occurrences that go on there. And there's all sorts of places in southern France where she was worshipped and she left her mark, and her energy is there.
And she adapted the teachings of Christ.
So. Yeah.
And we need to adapt because there's an imbalance of power in our society, like an imbalance of rich and poor and men and women. So now is really the time to bring the Mary Magdalene thing to light and balance out the world.
Yeah.
Yin and yang, masculine and feminine.
So now we're going to ask how to bring her gifts to humanity. I'll zoom in on this screen. You just push the button. Ready?
Okay.
How to bring her gifts to humanity.
Yes.
It's not working.
All right. Breathing. Maybe listen to the music while we wait. See if it will work. Having some technical difficulties.
Not working again. All right, well, we'll be back with more Electric Fortune Cookie. Okay.
All right, so we got our connection back again, and we want to ask our third question. How do we bring Mary Magdalene's gifts to humanity? Allay your fears among envisions.
Wow, allay your fears among envision. So if we overcome our fears and envision that happening and be among others who are doing the visioning, that's cute, I like that.
Envision, you want to enter the dream state.
Oh yeah, and overcome our fears.
I think she's been left out of the story because of different fears people have about women getting power. And then, I thought up here it's indelible in the libel because there's a lot of talk of her being, evil, prostitute, a threat to the Christian church. And you can believe whatever you want. But there's a lot of information out there that says that, there's a whole different story. if you accept the ultimate possibility of what's possible, then, you know, you can allow your fears and experience the vision.
Yeah, yeah. We also asked earlier, we asked the same question, and this is what we got.
Wait for festive sidetrack neighborhood choice, which is kind of like the similar thing with Among Envision. So creating a festive thing that would bring people together in their neighborhoods and give them a choice.
The neighborhoods, block parties and neighborhood churches, and bringing the knowledge that she had and making her gospel known to people, and how she talked about what was important in life, and
she should be celebrated.
And she should be celebrated and not denigrated. The Delilah thing, the lies of Delilah, you know, that women have been, you know, called whores and prostitutes, and men have been exonerated from that. And meanwhile, the church and men in general have been able to run rampant over women, killing them by the millions through inquisitions and burning them at the stake and all this nonsense. It's time for that to end.
Fear mongering. And here we have fears, ears, and vision. So basically, you know, become observant and alert, and make your own choices about what you believe.
Yeah, yeah. And then we asked another question about her earlier. It said, singer, resentful, observant, hale. And I had a friend who had a vision of Mary Magdalene that she sang. And that she sang as she was mourning Jesus with this moaning sound in her vision. And
singer sounds like sinner.
Yes, yeah, sin and sing.
But I guess instead of feeling resentful, she decided to sing and accept whatever, you know? Like, music is a good medicine for the soul, and resent can really damage a person.
Yeah. So, we should be hailing the singer and be observant not to get caught up in all the resentment.
Hey, Hail Mary.
Hail Mary, right.
And hail is like rain, you know, the rain, R-E-I-G-N.
Yeah. That women should have an equal voice in the world and not be relegated to being possessions and cattle and less than men. So she was somebody that was sent to us as very powerful, and that maybe she condescended to come to Earth because she knew what she was going to go through, being tormented like that. And that she brought a great deal of power, and maybe it was her love that helped resuscitate Jesus into his ascension. The ascension and the descension. And what happened to her? Indelible, adaptable secrecy. She was kept secret, and even though they tried to erase her, they couldn't completely erase her. And that she taught people about adaptability, how they set her adrift in the boat, and she somehow made it to France and is celebrated through France.
Oh, and I just thought this one right here, Allay Your Fears Among Envision. Wasn't there a story about Mary seeing Jesus in a vision and she wasn't afraid of him? And he said that she was blessed since the sight of him didn't scare her.
Right.
And that was sort of like the beginning of their relationship.
Well, it wasn't the beginning, but it was another step.
Okay.
Because she was the first to see him when he arose.
Yeah. I just thought that was a Bible story. Allay your fears among the vision. So don't be afraid of what you see, open your mind.
Right, and be among other visionaries.